gone.
The Marvel?
Congratulations. You made it all the way here. This is it. Your precious Wardstone. But what are you planning to do now, I could kill you where you stand, but wouldn't it be nice if you could die in battle like heroes? No. I want you to die in despair, scrabbling around like rats in the blighted ruins of your city, blind and broken. Your flesh scabbed and seeping, and every moment knowing precisely what was done to you.
Sounds terrifying. Except, that's how we've been living for generations.
There isn't a soul that can resist the temptations of the Abyss. Even a stone can be turned. I'm not joking. Your precious Wardstone. Weakened from the injury inflicted by Discari, has almost succumbed to my charms. So the whole barrier around the world wound, the gift of your useless goddess, will be a weapon of the Abyss. Just a little more, and boom! Every city with one of these eyesores stuck in the middle of it, from Canabras to Neurosian, will turn into smoking craters, and all the mortals into red sludge beneath our hooves. So you have a choice. Especially you, my pet. Kiss me on my dainty hoof. Pledge your loyalty to Baphomet. And when the world falls, its ruins shall be yours. Well, quite. What am I doing to it? Probably the same thing I did to many of your comrades. Sweetly and tenderly persuading it to abandon the mortals and join our side.
Prepare to fight to the death, demon! We won't let that happen.
You've already forgotten me. You mortals have awfully short memories. Even shorter than your little lives. Staunton, sweetums. Don't you want to introduce me to your friends properly? No? Well, I'd better do it myself. I am Minagho, Lily II and faithful servant of Baphomet, and leader of his armies. The city is mine now. I'm just starting to settle in, get things just how I like them. But once I'm finished, I promise you, the results will be simply to die for.
And it was such a charming little place until you sullied it with your presence. It had such lovely boulevards, quiet and shaded. You took those away from me, and I shan't forgive you for that.
They've done much worse things than spoil the promenades. All the people they've killed.
Yes, yes, of course, you're right. I grieve for the common folk as well.
Make me. One of the sweetest spoils of war is gloating over your broken and humiliated enemy. You want to deny me that pleasure?
They will break against our resolve.
Aperanus.
Send him.
Around now. You want to know what will happen when I'm done with the Wardstone? Here's a little demonstration.
Day, you woke up. Healing your wounds was easy, but you were unconscious for so long, I was starting to worry we'd lost you. We couldn't stand up to the demoness. Her spells were too strong. It's all right. We'll handle it somehow. You blacked out, but Staunton and I managed to get you here to the Defender's Heart. It used to be a tavern, but now it's our headquarters. We're gathering our forces here, and we're preparing to strike back. Bad, but not hopeless. We're constantly getting news, and new sources of resistance keep springing up in the districts where everyone seemed to be dead. The survivors are gathering here. You should see them. Their faces, their eyes, burning with determination. The city is destroyed, but our resistance is not broken. We will keep fighting. Demons have been filling Canabras with their spies and infiltrators for a long time. Unfortunately, I don't have enough people to attack the place right now, at least not blindly. I'd be grateful if you snuck in there and scouted out the situation, but just scouting. Don't be a hero. Heard what the demon said. They're going to desecrate the Wardstone and blow up the whole barrier around the World Wound. That would be an even worse disaster than the World Wound's expansion before the Second Crusade. Not only Canabras, but every city with a Wardstone will be destroyed, including the capital. We can't allow that no matter what. We will retake it, even destroy it if we must. Iomade's gift must not become a weapon of the Abyss. The Wardstones are a gift of Iomade. Created personally by her herald, a mighty angel, and a general of the Celestial Armies. The Wardstones keep the World Wound from expanding. They stand along the border of the territory controlled by the demons, creating a barrier to keep them inside. The Canabris Obelisk was the first to be placed. It is the key to the whole barrier. We cannot leave it in the hands of those monsters from the Abyss. First of all, we need to decide what to do with the stone once we get it. What I'm about to say is classified. A traveler came to the city recently. A blind elf calling himself the Storyteller. He insisted he be allowed to examine the Wardstone, and he raised the alarm when his study was finished. Even before the demon attack, he had found some damage or flaw in the stone. Prelate Hulrune dismissed his words as nonsense, borderline blasphemy. But between you and me, the prelate's opinion isn't worth much. I think the Storyteller knew what he was talking about. We could use his advice right now, if only we knew where he was. I remember the Storyteller spent a lot of time talking to Staunton, a dwarf from my unit. You saw him during the demon attack. The elf asked him about the history of the Crusades. Maybe the Storyteller told Staunton something about where we could find him if anything happened. There's another problem. After the attack, the demons began to gather their forces at the Grey Garrison. It'll be even harder to take them with a head-on assault. But I once heard soldiers talking about a secret entrance to the garrison. Trouble is, I have no idea where to look for it. While you explore the city, please keep your eyes open. In case you find something we can use. And one last thing. The Eagle Watch has lost a lot of soldiers recently. Some were killed, but others simply haven't been seen since the attack. In the chaos that is now Canabris, it's next to impossible to confirm anything for sure. One of the missing fighters is Janna Aldori. A new recruit in the Watch. She got along well with Sela. And she often went drinking with her. I honestly thought Sela and Janna had died together. But now Sela's returned with you and there's no sign of Janna. If you learn anything of her whereabouts when you're out in the city, please report back. May the goddess help you. We're still fighting, which means that Canabris still hasn't fallen. If you come across any groups in the city that can fight, send them here to the Defender's Heart. We'll need every fighter we can muster for the final assault. Yes, one more thing. If you're in the area, check out this address. It's our house. Mine and Anevia's. Well, it was our house. If the building is still standing, open the hidden compartment in the kitchen. It's filled with supplies for a rainy day. You can take whatever you find. You have more need of it.
Thank you.
Follow my steps.
Thank you. Let's head out. Thank you. if you dare.
Careful now.
Cover me!